Principles of Feng Shui, written by Simon Brown, read by Michael Maloney.
Oriental medicine and philosophy are based on the premise that along with all the physical aspects of our world that we can see, hear, touch, smell, and taste, there is a movement of a subtle flow of electromagnetic energy. Whereas your blood is carrying oxygen and nutrients, such as proteins, carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, and minerals, this qi energy carries your thoughts, ideas, emotions, and dreams in life. You may have had the experience of suddenly having a brilliant idea and immediately feeling physically different all over. Many people describe this as a tingling sensation. I believe the flow of qi energy explains why we feel so different physically, depending on our emotional state. The widespread interest in positive thinking provides one way of learning how to influence the quality of qi energy flowing through our bodies. If you can train yourself to think about your best characteristics, to plan optimistically for the future, and generate feelings of love, then it is this kind of energy that will be nourishing all the cells in your physical body. This could explain why some people have recovered from life-threatening illnesses by changing the way they think. One very important aspect is to realize not only that your thoughts and emotions affect the quality of your qi energy, and the qi energy influences the quality of each of your cells, but also that the quality of your cells influences the nature of the qi energy flowing through them, and this in turn influences your thoughts. There is a two-way dynamic. The big difference between qi energy and your blood is that, apart from menstruation, ideally your blood stays inside your skin, whereas qi energy extends typically 10 centimeters to 1 meter outside your skin. This makes your own qi energy easy to influence. The surrounding qi energy mixes with some of your qi energy. Similarly, every building has its own unique movement of qi energy. I think of this as the atmosphere of a place. In certain buildings, one naturally feels more inspired, energetic, and more positive, an uplifting atmosphere. However, the reverse is also true. I find spending a few hours in a large building, such as a shopping mall or a hospital, is physically draining and mentally disorientating, whereas when I'm out in the country, I can walk most of the day and still feel invigorated and emotionally content. In fact, I actually end up feeling better. Wherever you are, your own flow of qi energy is constantly being influenced by your surroundings. With Feng Shui, what we are primarily concerned with is what we can do in a building that will help the occupant's own qi energy flow in a way that will bring on better physical and emotional health. Once we have achieved this, all kinds of possibilities can open up for them. I once described Feng Shui to an acupuncturist friend as arranging your home so that you are constantly receiving the benefits of an acupuncture treatment. For example, once you have found the ideal location for your bed, those 6 to 8 hours you lie there will actually be enhancing the flow of qi around your body, so that each morning you could awake feeling physically refreshed, emotionally excited about a new day and clear-headed. Perhaps the best way to illustrate the movement of qi energy would be to imagine zooming away from our planet until you can look down at the Earth. Pretend you can see the air and water moving. Some areas will be calm, some will be experiencing quick, almost violent movements. Qi energy moves in similar patterns. One reason why the name Feng Shui, meaning wind-water, is such a good description is because the movement of qi energy mirrors the kind of movements we see in our own wind and water. For example, visualize fast-flowing water passing a sharp point. As it passes the point, the water begins to swirl, sometimes forming whirlpools. This also happens to air when wind passes a sharp corner. The flow of qi energy is exactly the same. It swirls around as it passes a protruding corner in a room. This swirling energy is called cutting qi and occurs wherever you encounter a sharp protruding corner. In restaurants and hotel lobbies, I have noticed that if a chair is positioned in front of a protruding corner, generally people are reluctant to sit in it. Placing yourself within this swirling spiral of energy will tend to make your own energy swirl around, causing you to feel more disorientated and more likely to feel confused. Over a long time, such as sleeping in front of such a corner, the constant immersion in swirling energy or cutting chi could eventually lead to ill health. Apart from protruding corners, there are other influences on the flow of qi energy to consider. Doors, windows, stairs, the shape of a building, the local landscape, and the direction a building faces will, all in their own way, influence the movement of qi energy around your home or office. Part of a feng shui practitioner's job is to identify how these features are affecting the flow of qi, and then find ways to create a more harmonious flow of qi energy. Often, some areas of the home will be experiencing fast, turbulent energy, whereas others may be very still and stagnant. I aim to create a situation where there is a harmonious flow throughout the home. When I began to practice feng shui, I was fascinated to observe how restaurants and shops in locations with poor feng shui would fail. When I talked to people working in one such building, they described it as though the building itself had bad luck. I have had clients who asked me to help because their marriage was breaking up, only to find that they bought the home from people who were selling because they were getting divorced, and that these people had also bought from a divorced couple before them. A building that has three generations of people living there ending up in divorce needs careful consideration before moving in. My own experience confirms that the home you live in carries its own particular movement of qi energy, and that this influences your own flow of qi energy, which in turn affects your emotional and physical well-being. By enhancing the flow of qi energy in your own home, you can make positive changes to yourself, which in turn lead to a greater ability to realize your own dreams in life. Chinese medicine and philosophy, the origins of feng shui, are based on the principles of yin and yang. These two words are used to describe everything around us and how this affects us. I assume that when these principles were being developed, people were mainly interested in farming, their basic material needs, and health. Yin and yang created a system whereby they could observe what happened in the past and then use this to predict the future. Let me give you an example. At the time of a full moon, the Chinese would say we become more yang. This means we're more active, want to go out, and generally are more social. Now, centuries later, this can be confirmed by statistics. Insurance companies will confirm that at the time of a full moon, accidents increase. The crime rate in New York goes up, and admissions to casualty wards increase. Conversely, at the time of a new moon, the ancient Chinese would say that we become more yin, that is, more peaceful, more spiritual, and more relaxed. So, armed with this simple piece of yin and yang information, if we wanted to organize a really wild party, when would be the best time? The full moon, of course. At this time, people will be more likely to want to go out and have fun. Yin and yang are the first of the essential points to be grasped in understanding the frameworks used in feng shui. To communicate and learn from experience, we need some kind of framework. For example, simple maths like addition.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.